The Pledge of Allegiance to the flag, and I would ask Counselor Jordan to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I don't know why that is. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America
and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
Citizens' discussion of items not on the agenda. Hearing none, we'll move on to, oh, Counselor Reed.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I request that we take an item out of order, please.
I'm sure the entire council would accede to that request.
Okay, then, whereas William H. Jordan served on the Cape Elizabeth Board of Selectmen from 1961 until 1967, and
whereas Bill Jordan served on the Cape Elizabeth Town Council from the inception of the Town Council in 1967 to 1979, and
whereas he returned to the Town Council in 1986 and served 12 additional years until 1998, and
whereas Selectman Jordan was chosen to lead the board in 1962 and in 1965, and
whereas Counselor Jordan was elected by his peers to serve as their chairman and as the head of the local government in 1969, 1970, 1971, 1977, 1989, and 1994, and
whereas Bill Jordan has served as chairman of the Ordinance Committee and of the Finance Committee of the Town Council during many of the years he served on the Town Council, and
whereas Bill Jordan assisted in the negotiations and with vision voted for the purchase of Fort Williams and the federal government, excuse me, from the federal government, and
whereas Mr. Jordan assisted in the creation of Crescent Beach State Park, the acquisition of Gull Crest Farm, the development of a local greenbelt, and the transfer of the Portland Headlight property to the town, and
whereas Bill Jordan was the key decision maker leading to the construction of the swimming pool at Cape Elizabeth High School and was a strong supporter of the creation of the community services program, and
whereas Mr. Jordan was instrumental in the creation of a municipal sewerage system that has vastly cleaned our local environment, and
whereas he assisted in the transition of the open burning dump on Spurwink Avenue to a site that is a model for refuse disposal and recycling, and
whereas Bill was a member of the building committee for Cape Elizabeth High School and for additions and renovations to the Pond Cove Elementary School and the Cape Elizabeth Middle School, and
whereas Mr. Jordan worked with the Public Works Department for many years helping with snow plowing during winter storms, and
whereas he has served the greater Portland community as a founding trustee of the Cumberland County Civic Center, as a member of the County Jail Building Committee, and as a member of the board of the Cape Elizabeth Home for the Aged, and
whereas Bill has volunteered his time with the Cumberland County Farm Bureau, with the Maine Farm Bureau, and with the Cooperative Extension Service, and has provided produce to countless town events over the years, and
whereas the Jordan Farm on Wells Road has been a great gathering spot in the community for the picking of strawberries, for kids who are ice skating, and for hearing the needs of citizens, and for advocating for their interests, and
whereas Bill Jordan has served as a member of Engine 2 Fire Company for 45 years, and served as a lieutenant and as captain of the company, and
whereas Bill was the appointed deputy chief of the Cape Elizabeth Fire Department from 1966 to 1980, and
whereas Bill led the Cape Elizabeth Fire Department as its chief from 1980 until 1986 during a period that required so much time that Bill served as the last part-time volunteer fire chief, and
whereas Bill Jordan has been the chief annual organizer of the Fire Department Lobster Stew, which has benefited the Fire Department Relief Association and Engine 2 Company, and
whereas Bill Jordan has always stood for open government and providing all citizens an opportunity to participate in local decision-making, and
whereas the members of the Cape Elizabeth Board of Selectmen and the Town Council have admired Bill Jordan's total devotion to Cape Elizabeth for over 45 years, and
whereas Bill will be retiring from the Town Council on June 8, 1998, but will continue to serve the community as a member of the Facilities 2000 Committee and as a member of Engine 2 Company. Now.
Whereas, be it resolved.
Therefore.
Oh, therefore, be it resolved. The Cape Elizabeth Town Council hereby expresses the sentiments of the entire community in wishing Bill the happiest of retirements, and we thank him for his entire outstanding record of service to the community, and be it further resolved that to honor Bill Jordan and to be reminded of all his good works for the town of Cape Elizabeth, the Cape Elizabeth Town Council hereby designates the room behind the council chamber as the William H. Jordan Conference Room with a suitable plaque to be installed. Dated this 11th day of May, 1998, at Cape Elizabeth, Maine, signed by all the sitting councilors. Congratulations, Bill.
I'm okay to say something.
You can do whatever you want.
See, my family's in the back room, and I don't know if they should have heard all this, but how good I am. But I just want to say about the room, I thank you for that. But when I was a boy, as you might say, I went to school in this building for 4 years, and there was a stage there, and one night I was elected to shut the lights off, and I fell off the stage. Glad I'm remembered in that. Thank you, and I appreciate all this. I didn't know it was going to take quite so long to read, but thanks anyway.
Presentations, and I have one. I'm going to podium.
Increase the value of this award to all who will receive it in the future.
Knowing that Bill Jordan was the 1998 recipient will make all past and future recipients know that they are the cream of the crop in Cape Elizabeth. Bill, on behalf of the town council and on behalf of the entire town, thank you, congratulations, and if you will come and receive this award.
Oh, this is it.
We do have a battery for you, too.
Batteries included.
For those of you at home who missed the reception earlier this evening, it was a wonderful event for this town. The town presented and individuals presented numerous gifts. The reception was made possible in large part by the work of a few very dedicated individuals. Sue King from the school side prepared all the food, and Barbara Ray, the town manager's secretary, was instrumental in the organization. It was wonderful to see individuals from many different walks of life and all different ages, and they were there for one reason, and that was to say thanks to Bill Jordan. Yeah. Are there any other presentations at this point in time? Well, Mr. Fisher.
Been about somebody who's been a person of action, and so I think it's very appropriate that in this last year of being on the council, two very important issues, or two very important events are taking place right now. One is the purchase of the land beside the town transfer station, and where the new public works department is going to go. And there's also going to be two fields built there, really, at our end of town, if you will. And it's something that I know you wanted to see happen for a long period of time. And the other piece is something that you've supported all along, and that's the breaking of ground, which was supposed to happen last week, but today, or the weather has kind of hasn't allowed it to happen. Of the two new fields, one at Fort Williams and the one at Lyons Field, I think that in your last year of service, I think it's very appropriate that those two things have taken place. In any event, I'd really like to present this. If you want me to walk over there, please.
No, I'm able.
He's able.
Reports and correspondence. Are there any members of the town council with a report? Councilor McGinty.
I know this is Billy's night, but I think I'd be remiss if I did not thank the voters of Cape Elizabeth who re-elected me to the town council. I'm certainly honored to be re-elected and humbled by the vote, and I hope Billy's certainly been an inspiration. His loyalty to this town and his devotion to this town council, he's been an inspiration certainly for me. I don't intend to be here for 30 years, but if I could be a tenth of the town councilor that Billy's done, I hope I will have done a good job. So thank you to the voters, and thank you to Billy.
Thank you.
Any other reports? I have one. The band concert is this Wednesday at the middle school. For those of you who don't know, it's a very special band concert. Tony Baffa, it's his last one. He's been another one of those citizens and employees here that have meant so much to this town, and I hope many of you will take the time out of your busy lives to come to that concert. Other reports and correspondence. The minutes of the previous meeting. Is there a motion?
Mr. Chairman, I move that the minutes of the previous meeting in April be approved as read.
Second?
Second.
Second by Councilor McGinty. All in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
Mr. Chair, we also have minutes from the April 15th meeting number 16, 97-98.
And is that a motion to...
For approval.
Second? By Councilor Fritz. All in favor? Opposed? It's unanimous. Item number 134. This was an item that was tabled on 4/13/98. Is there a motion to bring this particular issue, the appointment of the Republican Party representative to Voter Registration Appeals Board, back before the council?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor? The item is now before the town council. Is there a motion?
I'll move that John Doyen be the representative, please.
Second.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that John Doyen be the Republican Party representative to the Voter Registration Appeals Board. Discussion? Hearing none. All in favor? Opposed? It's unanimous. Item 155. Receipt of the Town Farm Working Group.
With
154.
154, mine says 155.
You got the earlier one.
Oh, sorry. I have a 154, that's right. This was another... Oh, I'm sorry. Item 154 was, again, an item that was tabled on 5498. The item is consideration of request for Fort Williams Advisory Commission to study how to make Fort Williams Park self-sufficient. Is there a motion to take this item off the table and bring it before the Town Council for consideration? Councilor Reed?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Councilor Fritz. Discussion on the motion to bring this item before the Town Council. Hearing none. All in favor? Opposed? It's unanimous. The item is now before the Town Council. Is there a motion? Councilor Beyer?
I'd like to move that we convey the proposal or the letter that is in the minutes to the Fort Williams Advisory Commission, which essentially asks them by next February to review various ways to make the fort more self-sufficient financially in terms of both capital and operating expenses.
Sir, second by Councilor Berry. Discussion. Councilor Fritz.
Mr. Chair, I would like to amend the objective statement. It states at the present time determine how to make Fort Williams self-sufficient. I would like to add as an amendment, while not sacrificing any of the park's current philosophy or policy objectives.
Is there a second to the... does the individual who made, Mr. Beyer, made the motion, do you accept the amendment?
I think no. I don't, not without further understanding of what the objective is.
Is there a second to the amendment? Hearing none, the amendment fails. Further discussion. Councilor McGinty.
Just a clarification on the objective. To make it financially self-sufficient, is that what we're talking about? Is it self-sufficient? That's what we're really talking about, right?
Yes.
If I might comment, that my concern is the vague wording of this to make it self-sufficient. Does that, if you took it to an extreme, the committee could possibly say, well, in order to make it self-sufficient, we could sell half of the park and have a restaurant or sell it for condominiums or whatever. We have a policy that is established that protects the natural area, the scenic views, the recreational aspect, and I think their recommendations ought to be within the philosophy of the park as it stands now.
I would assume that the Fort Williams Advisory Committee well knows the existing town policies and can certainly read this letter and will be applying existing town policies and considering existing town policies when they make any recommendations to us. Further discussion. Councilor Reed.
Mr. Chairman, just a different position than Councilor Fritz perhaps would be my position, that I would hope that the Fort Williams Advisory Commission would make this a brainstorming session, would come up with some ideas that are well within the policies that are established in the master plan for Fort Williams and in the town's practices. And I hope that with the exception of adding the word financially self-sufficient, that we allow this charge to go forward.
Further discussion?
No, Councilor Gordon. Just want to say that I kind of agreed with Councilor Reed there. I don't think it would do any harm. Let them look at it. Let the people know what it would happen to it. And I think it would be a good thing. If they want to spend that time on it, I feel that they should look at it. But I don't think they will. They should have that choice. Somebody on the committee. That's all.
Further discussion. Councilor McGinty.
I'm wondering, we have the chairman of the committee here, the commission here. I wonder if he needs clarification or if he understands what the charge is, if he wishes to comment.
Well, One more. Dan, could you come to the podium and introduce yourself? And state where you live, please. We want to make sure you live in this town.
Dan Fisher, I'm the chair of the Fort Wayne Advisory Commission. I live at 2 Pheasant Hill Road. I'd just like to comment on what Carol said, in that I don't know whether it needs to be in the charge, but I think that it's got to be within what the policies are that are part of what Fort Wayne's, of the Fort Wayne's master plan. And what has gone on prior to the history of the commissions and the committees that have worked on for Wayne's and the policies to where they are today. And I think that whether it's within the charge that you give us or not, I think it has to be part of what we do in terms of developing a plan for self-sufficiency.
Thank you. I think for those individuals at home, although it might take a moment, I think it would be advisable to Councilor Beyer to let people understand what is being sent to the Fort Williams Advisory Commission. And if you could read it, I think it would be educational for all.
Be happy to. Thank you. Please bear with my reading. This is a memorandum proposed to go to the Fort Williams Advisory Commission from the Cape Elizabeth Town Council regarding a study to determine how to make a Fort Williams park self-sufficient, dated today. During the recent deliberations of the Finance Committee consisting of the whole Town Council, there was a consensus to ask the Fort Williams Advisory Commission to review policies and practices that would enable Fort Williams Park to become financially self-sufficient. Self-sufficiency is defined as recovering within the park all capital and operating expenses, including overhead. Town Council has identified the following outline of how this review might occur. We also recognize that the committee may need some support in helping to prepare your written report. Please feel free to request this assistance through the town manager. Objective: determine how to make Fort Williams Park self-sufficient. Tasks: identify the following. The current municipal support for Fort Williams Park, current and future capital needs over perhaps a 10-year period of time, the desirability of portable or permanent restrooms, the future of the guarded mansion, long-term use of buildings for municipal or rental purposes, identify all possible solutions with creativity and with open minds, and include at least plans for donations, bequests, corporate sponsors, etc., consultation with director of the museum at Portland Headlight, potential for parking fee, paren, where, how, dollars, etc., close paren, residents, non-residents, buses, question mark. Project use for the fort slash congestion and solutions to ensure that town residents don't get shut out by traffic, etc. Alternate fee sources such as filming, video camera fees, licensing, etc. List all pros and cons with each idea to allow quantification, parentheses dollars, as well as subjective factors to be considered. Conduct a public forum after the fact-finding portion of your work. Report back to the Town Council by February 28, 1999. Town Council appreciates your willingness to serve on the Fort Williams Advisory Commission. We believe your work will help us set a clear direction for the park for many years to come. Thank you.
Further discussion on the proposal to send forward this letter to the Fort Williams Advisory Commission. Hearing none, call for a vote. All in favor? Opposed? Is it unanimous?
Yes,
it was.
It's unanimous.
Thank you.
Item 155, receipt of report of the Town Farm Working Group. In the councilor's packets was a report prepared by what was classified as a technical committee. Councilor Jordan was on that committee. That report is now here, and is there a motion to receive that report at this time. Counselor Reed.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion to receive it. I would also like to make a subsequent statement, and that is that in addition to receiving this report, I would ask that we refer and authorize the town manager to work with the town attorney and the town planner in preparing draft easement and zoning language in the full spirit of what has been recommended by the technical committee. Refer this to a public, a workshop with the town council with subsequent public hearing and public notice of an agenda item for further discussion.
I'll second that motion.
Discussion. Counselor McGinty.
I would like to see this go to a workshop first, that we can sit down and talk about this. I mean, we've only had it for a couple of days. The whole reason for the technical committee was so we could get some advice back to look at some, you know, policies, procedures, whatever, with easements. And I would rather refer this to a workshop with the new council, the new sitting council, so it'll be after June 8th, I guess, and so we can sit down and talk face-to-face with the members of the committee, discuss it, and maybe then refer it. I'd prefer to do that.
No problem.
Counselor Reed, you accept that amendment?
Yes.
So with that amendment, it would be simply that this report be received and the report referred to a workshop to be scheduled as expeditiously as possible with the members of the new council. And who seconded the original motion?
I did.
And do you accept the amendment, Counselor Berry?
With emphasis on the word expeditiously.
Since the amendment has been accepted by the individual who proposed the motion and the individual seconded it, that is now part of the motion. Is there discussion on the motion as it presently stands? Counselor?
I think that this is quite a complete report that we have received, and I think that this committee has done some extremely important research in looking into what we asked them to look into in terms of providing samples of easements that other towns have joined into with conservation organizations, and I think that they have come back with a very kind of middle ground where their proposal is to have a general kind of open space recreation public kind of easement with a land trust kind of organization, and then having specific policy be drawn up through zoning ordinance. And I think that that is a very sound middle ground kind of approach that answers the concerns that the council has addressed when we've had this come before us in the past. In the form of a workshop already. I'd like to see this translated into a draft for us to look over before we have a workshop. I think we need to move forward on this in terms of providing public open space for recreation.
Further discussion. Councilor Beyer.
I'm going to respectfully at least state a slightly different opinion. I want to make sure that we do this right, because it's a gorgeous piece of property, and I want to make sure that it's not only kept that way for the short term, but that it really works for our great-great-great-grandchildren, should they be fortunate enough to be here. And having read over the material and having attended the other workshop, the conclusion that I reach is the devil is going to be in the details on this one. I think until we have things that are really written down and we can really look at them and think them through and assess that, I'm not going to be comfortable in giving anything away or signing anything away until I'm really sure of those details. So I'm perfectly happy with the workshop, and I apologize if we have to spend a little more time to get it right. That's okay with me.
Further discussion.
I don't think there's any intention to not have us deal with details by saying that we would favor the recommendations of this technical committee tonight and to proceed in the flavor of what they have recommended and then deal with the details when we have a draft.
Further discussion?
But just to respond to that, I don't, you may be entirely right, and this may be fine the way it is. I'm quite open-minded to that. I just don't want to start closing doors on us before I feel that I entirely understand it. And I don't feel that yet. That's my concern.
Can I go? I was a member of the town council on this committee, along with the former town councilor, and sat through all the meetings. And I believe when the town council had a workshop, one of the issues at the workshop was we felt that as a council, we needed a little more information, a little technical assistance to continue our workshop. My recollection was we were not at the stage of making any recommendations of any kind, and in fact asked the technical committee to get us information. I still think we are at the stage where the town council needs to sit and talk about this and take our time. We're in the driver's seat in this one. We own this piece of property. There's nothing that's happening in the next 3 weeks, 4 weeks, month to this piece of property that the town council can't control. And I agree with Councilor Beyer that before we go down any road, the council as a whole should have an opportunity to sit in an informal setting and have a wide-ranging discussion. And we're just premature. The committee spent a long time on this issue with different views. And that's why the report never resolved how best to preserve this piece of land. There is no hurry, and that we should take our time and be deliberate. There's a time for action, and there's a time to be deliberate. And in my view, this is the time to be deliberate, not to rush forward for I don't know what reason.
I'd like to hear comments from the committee, if we might. We haven't, they're presenting their report, but we haven't heard anything from it.
Well, and I think
I don't know if they have anything.
And I think the reason for that is that the procedure of this town, as we have developed it over the years, Councillor Fritz, has been that reports are received, and this wasn't a committee formed, this was a technical committee formed to help provide information for the town council to continue its workshop. If we get into an extended discussion tonight, and obviously if there's votes to do this, we will, but if people start taking positions tonight and getting in one camp or another camp, or without really having an opportunity as a council, especially with the new council members coming on, to sit and talk about this in an informal setting, I think we're doing the town a disservice. But if there is a motion to have further discussion of this, well, right now, the only motion before the council is to receive the report and refer it to a workshop. If after we vote on that motion, Councillor Fritz, if you have some other motion, you certainly are free to raise it. Councillor Reed.
I just have one observation. I don't think I'm the only town councillor who's already received calls on this issue. And there are people forming opinions who haven't seen the report. I think we owe it to the people in this town to have a workshop so that we can hear the information, we can discuss the pros and cons. We were not all present at those committee meetings, and we need to hear the pros and cons of the different ways of doing things. And having said that, Mr. Chairman, could I move the question?
You may. All in favor of the motion? Opposed? Motion carries 6-1 with Councillor Fritz opposed. Item 156.
Mr. Chairman, before we leave that, is there any way we could set a date for a workshop?
Let me confer with the town manager. Is there a date? We have a workshop on June 1st concerning the pool. I'm not suggesting this will be the only workshop on this particular item, but it very well could be time to get started, and we could also set this item to workshop that particular evening.
Can we do that then?
With the expectation we probably won't get done, but it would be a start. Is that acceptable to the council members?
I would just think that the pool is going to take a lot of time, I think. I mean, maybe not, but I think that the pool report is going to take a lot of time. I don't want to do a disservice to this report by having it, you know, later in the evening where we all want to go home. And maybe we could find another time. I mean, we can put it on the agenda and see what happens.
Well, how about that, Councilor McGinty? We put it on the agenda full well knowing we might not get to it, but we will not leave that workshop without setting a specific date if for this particular item at another workshop.
That's
and that would, I believe, satisfy Councilor Berry to move this along. Is that acceptable?
That's fine with me, sure.
Anybody have any problem with that?
I guess I don't know that I have a problem. I just feel badly for these folks if they have to show up and sit around and then we don't meet. If we know the pool committee is going to go for a while, we ought to just come up with a new schedule.
Try to do one on June 15th. That's a Monday.
What do you think?
Well, how about this, that the next time that I believe we could do this would be Monday, June 15th. And I would still like to, if the pool gets done for some reason, I mean, I would like to have this at least listed so that the council, if we have an opportunity, we can start to discuss it. But we would then have a backup date of June 15th, and we know we're not going to get, even if we start discussing this particular item, we're not going to get done.
And the June 1st one starts at 7, does it not? So that would give us a little extra time.
7 o'clock, June 1st?
The June 1st one at 7 is a council caucus to organize for the next year. There's already a possibility that if you don't complete that in a half an hour, you would need to continue that after the workshop on the pool.
Well, I mean, it certainly looks like the 15th is, we're not going to get to it to the 15th.
Yeah. And maybe you need to reiterate, Mr. Chair, that, you know, we're not going to do anything with this property. I don't think there's anybody on this council who has any intention of doing anything but preserving it. Certainly, that's my feelings. It's a matter of basically how. And, you know, there's no pressing need in the next 2 weeks to figure that out. I agree with Bill Byer that let's do it right, make sure it's preserved for generations the way we need to do it. So I think the 15th is the best bet.
Well said. Is there a consensus then to set this for workshop on June 15th?
7:30.
Mr. Chairman, I still think it would be, since we have members of the technical committee here, it would be a good time for them to tell us some of what they did. This is an opportunity for the public to learn about what they did. The public doesn't hear what we do in or any reports in workshop sessions. So I think if they would like an opportunity to say something, it would be appropriate.
My problem with that is I personally, the council wants that to happen. We can certainly, you can make that in the form of a motion and we can vote. I do not believe that's appropriate tonight because I think we're at such a formative stage that I think it would cause discussion in a forum, in a public forum, where people are getting locked into positions, we're discussing things in a way without going back to the basics and having a much more informal setting. I'm opposed to that, but if you wish to make a motion.
Well, I'm not as suggesting that we have a discussion. I'm just saying that the chairman might want to say something about what their committee had included in this report to us.
Councilor Jordan, do you believe,
yes, sir.
Do you believe that you as a member of the town council on this committee, would you like to, is there anything you would like to say, or do you believe this would be better served to go to workshop?
I think it should go to a workshop, period, but I mean, I would like to hear from the chairman of the committee to see if they got anything special that you could be thinking of in the meantime. That's all I was thinking.
So you would like to hear from the chairperson of the committee?
Yes.
And we are going to do what Councilor Jordan wants.
Was there a chairman of the technical committee?
I didn't believe there was a chair, but
comment? Out of this committee, there wasn't a chair.
I mean, this wasn't our typical committee. I mean, this was simply a very short-term committee.
Yeah.
Is there anything you'd like to say about this report, Councilor Jordan?
Well, No, all I can say about it, I read the report and I worked on it with them, and I think a lot, I think a lot of consideration's going to be given into what another entity is and how they're involved in the poor farm. And I think they have sent out a couple of good suggestions, and there's one of them there that I could endorse if I was there legally.
Well, does that satisfy you, Councilor Fritz, that we've heard from the committee?
Well, I don't know if anybody else on the committee had anything they wanted to say or not. I just, okay.
Hearing none. The item 156, receipt of report from Planning Board on proposed amendment to the subdivision ordinance that would permit the Planning Board to waive the requirement that there be a sidewalk on every road in each subdivision. Mr. McGovern.
Yes, the Planning Board voted 4-2 to refer this back to the Council, as referred to them several months ago. This came up in two instances. One, when the Dominica's Crossing subdivision was approved, which is the subdivision off Wells Road, we started adding up the mileage of the sidewalks that the town would have to maintain, and my recollection is it's over 1.2 miles or 2.1 miles, or one and two reminds me. It was a lot of sidewalk. And some of that's on little dead ends that are up within that subdivision. And when you get those types of streets that are dead ends, people just don't use sidewalks. And it was quite a maintenance obligation. It was felt that the Planning Board ought to be able to look at them on an individual basis. The second issue that came up was on Jordan Farm Road, which is the Peter Kennedy subdivision. Between the Kaplan's property and the Boxer's property, and particularly on the Kaplan side, there was a sidewalk due to go in there. The Kaplan's were vehemently opposed to the sidewalk going in there. They have a nice lawn there. They don't want it interrupted. It's paved for a short section, becomes a dirt road anyway. It was felt that no one would use the sidewalk because it's a dead end. They're going to use the dead end emergency access road. They're going to use that section anyway. So therefore, that maybe that would be one that might be waived, a sidewalk requirement. So anyway, the Planning Board looked at it, and it was a 4-2 vote. Mr. Emery from the Planning Board is here. I don't think he's here on this item, but you know, my sense is that the two people, knowing them, who voted not to recommend it, are very pedestrian-oriented and feel that for safety reasons that there probably ought to be sidewalks. I don't know. That's conjecture, knowing their background. But anyway, the clear majority, 2-1, did recommend that this move forward, and I'd like to recommend that you set a public hearing on it for your June 8th meeting at 7:30.
Is there such a motion? Councilor Reed.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Second by Councilor Jordan. Discussion?
Is that the usual order, is that it goes to public hearing before the ordinance committee, or does it go ordinance committee and then?
Respond to that. Usually the ordinance committee, this has been technically reviewed by the Planning Board, usually the ordinance committee tends to look at issues that have broad policy issues, that have a lot of complex issues that need to be looked at, similar to the vote we had earlier or last week in town that was quite a complicated issue. This is straightforward. You're either for it or you're against it, and it's felt that it doesn't need that second level of review. Unless the ordinance committee is dying for work and wants to look at it or would like to have a shot at it, it just seemed fairly straightforward.
Further discussion? Hearing none, call the question. I'm sorry.
Well,
Councilor Berry?
I'm just wondering if subdivisions are approved without sidewalks, that then the town takes over that area. Then in the future, we are going to be asked at town expense to install sidewalks in these areas where the people developing the property could be required to do it now. I'm concerned about future town expense, and I don't know the answers to that those questions, but I think they should be explored. I suppose that could be handled at a public hearing. I think that the area that you mentioned, that the town manager mentions, Two Lights Road on the Jordan Farm Road. That would, in the future, perhaps be broadened, or that dirt section might be cut through there. If that happens, then people might want sidewalks because of the increased traffic there. So perhaps this is a planning board issue, perhaps this is a council issue, I'm not sure. At any rate, I think these concerns should be addressed.
The motion at this point in time is that it be referred to a public hearing on June 8, 1998. Is there further discussion on this motion? Hearing none, all in favor of the motion? Opposed, it's unanimous, 7-0. Motion carries. Item 157, request to extend the tenure of the Telecommunications Facilities Task Force. Mr. McGovern.
This is a group that's looking at the impact of telecommunications technology on the community, and particularly how it affects towers. There's a lot of folks in town who have cellular phones and PCS devices, and that's creating more and more impact for towers. This committee has been studying the issue, has been doing a good job. They've identified a number of issues of potential of how the need for the technology can be addressed without negatively impacting the aesthetics of the community. They're so pleased with their work and so much enjoying it that they'd like 6 more months to do it, to spend the summer studying this fascinating issue. And they've asked for a 6-month extension from the original expiration date of May 1, 1998, which would bring them to November 1 of 1998. Did I say 88? 1998.
Nope. Is there such a motion?
I so move.
Councilman? Seconded by Councilor Fritz. Discussion? Councilor McGinty.
Is there any reason, and I don't know the answer to this, and maybe the town manager does, is there any reason that we would not want to give them an extension because it's such an important issue that something could happen in the meantime?
The industry, or there are some representatives of the industry who are working with the committee providing them good advice. Also, we continue to have pending applications before the planning board. There's one right now, some outfit called OmniPoint, that is continuing to put antenna additions onto existing towers over on Strokes Hill. That those seem to be working their way orderly through the planning board process. We haven't had any proposal, heard rumors of proposals for additional sites. You hear this talk about putting it on water towers, of hiding them in church steeples, and you know, those are the type issues that this committee is looking at. But we know of no danger with extension. There's always the possibility, but right now we only allow towers in resource protection districts. And there's certain standards that one needs to follow in order to meet that. So the Strouts Hill seems to be working just fine.
Okay. That was my concern, whether we were facing any danger, as you put it, I guess.
Further discussion? Hearing none, call the question. All in favor of the motion? Opposed? It carries unanimously. Item 158, approval of warrant for June primary. Madam Clerk.
Thank you very much. We are going to the polls again Tuesday, June 9th. I believe in the Portland Press Herald recently they said Tuesday, June 2nd, so I do want to clarify that. It is Tuesday, June 9th, and I would ask that the council authorize the polls to be open at 7 a.m. so that I may place that and include it on the notice of election that will be posted in the community.
I so move.
Is there a second?
Second.
Seconded by Councilor McGinty. Discussion? Hearing none, call a question. All in favor? Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Item 159, a request from the Fort William Centennial Committee to provide $7,500 in seed money for the celebration. Mr. McGovern.
Yes, the town council had a workshop last week with the Fort William Centennial Committee. They have very ambitious plans to commemorate the history of Fort Williams in a number of ways, the 100th anniversary of its creation or its establishment as a military installation. As part of the celebration, the committee is looking at raising 90% or up to 100% of the funds required. In order to get started doing this, they'd like the town council to provide a little bit of seed money to the tune of $7,500. The events being planned are a pictograph, for lack of a better term, it's got to be a better term, of some of the military history of the park that would be on the face of Battery Blair. They're looking at a celebration evening in mid-July that includes both fireworks and a laser show. Also, some walking tours and, you know, just an awful lot of good stuff that commemorates the military history of Fort Williams back before Councilor Jordan voted to buy it. So they're looking for $7,500, and it would come from undesignated surplus.
Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion.
Councilor McGinty?
I move that the Town Council approve the request from the Fort Williams Centennial Committee for $7,500 in seed money for the celebration.
Second.
Second by Councilor Reed. Further discussion? Hearing none, call question. All in favor? Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Next item is item 160. Well, we'll skip that for a moment. Citizens' discussion of items not on the agenda. Is there any citizen who wishes to discuss an item that was not on the agenda tonight? Hearing none. Item 160. Request to enter executive session to discuss a request for a hardship abatement and to discuss the status of collective bargaining with Local 340 of the Teamsters representing Public Works employees. Is there such a motion to enter executive session for those stated purposes?
Move.
Councilor Byer.
Second.
Seconded by Councilor Jordan. Discussion? Hearing none. Call the question. All in favor? Opposed? Carries 7-0. It is not anticipated that we will be back in public session tonight.
I have that leased the other last meeting.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Chairman. And that we adjourn in honor of the 30 years plus service that Billy Jordan has provided to the town of Cape Elizabeth.
Are we adjourning right now?
No, we got
to. Technically, I don't think we can adjourn, is the problem, because we're going into executive session. But I think we can all echo again our thanks to Councilor Jordan for his long years of service, and we look forward to being with him in our last executive session. Councilor Jordan?
Yes, I would like to say thank the present council for putting up with me for a few years here, and also all the other councilors that's been in Cape on the board in years past. And I've enjoyed it. I really have enjoyed it. And I, in some way, was hesitant and giving up, but I figure under the conditions around the family that it was a wise idea to pass now and be on with my business at home. I'll be around, though, I just want to say. I'm not giving up forever. As I told Michael back when I took the fire chief's job there for a short while, I'll be back. That's what I said. And like Douglas MacArthur said, old soldiers never die, they just fade away. Thank you.
And with that, we're going to executive session. It's not anticipated we will be coming back.